back your damn book.
Well, surely this can wait until...
After all, why the hell should I care what's in it if you don't?
You're not making sense.
No? What the hell is that Narn ship still doing here?
I discussed the situation with War Leader Nakal. He felt it was better to conserve our resources.
Did he? Well, how practical of him.
Oh,
no, 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 never mind. You're right. He's right. Everybody's right. Let's just look out for ourselves. When that cruiser popped out of hyperspace, we should have done the same thing. We should have just let the Centauri take custody of it in the first place, instead of sending out our ships and our pilots to defend it.
Well, he doesn't want to go.
Of course he doesn't. It's easy to fight when you got a lot of ships to work with. The real crunch comes when you're down to almost nothing. Then you either play it safe, and you probably lose it all, or you take a chance. After everything we've been through with your people, Sheridan was crazy to send our pilots out to fight for your ship. They didn't want to go. They didn't want to get blown out of the sky and leave B-5 defenses, and they sure as hell didn't want to die. But they did it because Sheridan told them to do it, and because it was right.
This time it is possible he could be wrong.
Yeah, it's possible. But you don't follow an order because you know for sure it's going to work out. You do what you're told because your CO has the moral authority that says you may not come back. But the cause is just and fair and necessary. That's why Sheridan's out there. And damn it, that's where that cruiser should be too. It's not Nakal's decision, Jakar. He doesn't see the big picture. You do. So in my book, and your book, that makes it your responsibility. Deal with it.